Hello, all you awesome people out there. Welcome or welcome back to the Geek Visions Podcast, the podcast that is dedicated to the big three of visual media, that being film, video games, and television. I am your host, as always, Hoover, and we have here today our roundup of a few things that were revealed and talked about at San Diego Comic-Con 2022. I'm not gonna lie, Comic-Con snuck up on me this year after not having anything in 2020, and then 2021, it being an online thing. This year really kind of, it really stuck up on me. I think I literally like was talking to a cousin of mine, and he asked what it was, and I looked up the date, and just like the moment, it just didn't shine on me like it was in like 2 weeks. So this kind of really stuck up on me, but here we are. So we're going to talk about a few things that were revealed here. Also, I mentioned in my last episode that this is kind of gonna act as like the news drop break, mostly because any stuff I was gonna talk about during the news drop was gonna be a lot of the stuff that got revealed here anyway. So this is where we are. Time to take a pause. Also, we are in the midst of what I'm dubbing as the summer reviews. We got a lot of reviews. We got a lot of stuff already done, by the way. I just wrapped up my review for Stranger Things Season 4, so please go listen to that. We also have reviews on Obi-Wan Kenobi, reviews on Barry, review on Young Justice, and Atlanta, and a bunch of other things that are still yet to come, so please go listen to all those if you're interested in any of those reviews, and we still got a few more to come. But for now, we're talking about things that were talked about during San Diego Comic-Con 2022. All right, so first off, let's just talk about a few, let's talk about Marvel Animation first. So Marvel had a little panel to talk about all of the animated properties and things of that nature that they have coming up. So first thing they revealed the first trailer for the I Am Groot miniseries that's going to be coming in August of 2022. It kind of just shows young baby Groot on just random adventures. I believe it's a 5-episode run. Just Groot. A little mini Groot on a bunch of just random adventures across the cosmos. So just a little fun little thing for the kiddies, for the children. And any other Marvel, I'm pretty sure adults are going to watch this too. So, but yeah, we got that coming. We also had some more news on X-Men 97, the animated series. The first X-Men animated series since Disney Marvel kind of took over with the Marvel stuff. And the first since they got the X-Men rights back. So, of course, X-Men 97 is just going to be the continuation of the classic 90s X-Men animated series. This is going to be coming in 2023. They revealed a look at the characters. So we still have our main group of characters in there. Cyclops, Jean Grey, Wolverine, Professor X, Rogue, Storm, Gambit, Jubilee, and Beast. I believe I said everybody in there. So everybody still have like the same outfits, just, you know, a little more cleaner, a little bit more updated for modern animation. Storm's hair is different. She kind of looks like how she has for like her Morlock, I think it was her outfit, kind of like the Mohawk thing going on. But so that's coming in 2023, and that is also getting a season 2, so that should be pretty cool. They also talked about Spider-Man Freshman Year, which is going to act as the, well, I guess it was supposed to act as the MCU origins of the MCU's Peter Parker, of Tom Holland's Spider-Man. But a lot of the stuff they revealed that's going to be happening on this show really put the continuity into question. Like, first of all, it definitely seems like the series is not going to be his original origin story. It seems like it's also going to kind of be a what if storyline, if you will, because in it, it's going to show Peter Parker actually meeting Norman Osborn instead of Tony Stark. So Norman Osborn is going to be in the show, which it was clearly established in Spider-Man No Way Home. Norman Osborn and Oscorp do not exist in this universe. So yeah, that's weird. But it also got a lot more confusing of a few more details that reveal mostly the villains that were supposed to be appearing in this series. So yeah, so some of the villains that are expected to pop up in this series include Dr. Octopus, which was yet another person that was revealed to not exist in this universe in No Way Home. Rhino, the Scorpion, Speed Demon, and Tarantula are all villains that are expected to make an appearance in this series. Also, some of Peter's group of friends in this series is going to include Amadeus Cho, which is a boy genius who in the comics also took on the mantle of, I think he took on the mantle of Iron Spider in one of the cartoons, but in the comics he eventually becomes the totally awesome Hulk. He becomes a Hulk in the series. And also Nico Minoru, who is known from The Runaways, is also going to be in this series, as well as, of course, Harry Osborn, with Norman appearing in the show. Of course, Harry is going to be in here too. And it's also going to have an appearance by Matt Murdock, Daredevil, who will be voiced by Charlie Cox as well. So yeah, its placement in the canon and in the universal MCU is very confusing and it's very weird. And it seems like this is going to be a big entire season of like a what if episode just made into an entire season, it seems like. But yes, but of course not just one season, as they also revealed that freshman year is going to also have a second season, and that season is going to be, of course, called Spider-Man Sophomore Year. So yeah, so Spider-Man Freshman Year is going to be coming out in 2024, so we got quite of a wait for that one. They also kind of talked a little bit more of Marvel Zombies, the basically spinoff series of what if episode. Also speaking of that, What If is also getting a season 2, so that should be cool. And of course, and they already confirmed that we're going to explore more on Captain Carter, and kind of where we left off from season 1, was finding the Hydra Stomper on the ship. And it seems like the first episode is actually going to be like a Winter Soldier-esque spin coming out of that, which of course we all kind of expected that, with Steve kind of being in the Hydra Stomper, frozen in a capsule found on a ship. We kind of figured that was kind of going to be the Winter Soldier spin for Captain Carter, or instead of Bucky, it was going to be Steve in the Hydra Stomper. So that seems like it's going to be the first arc we cover in season 2 of What If. Hopefully also What If gives us that episode that got cut from season 1, that weird episode that just kind of happened out of nowhere with Gamora kind of killing Thanos, that they just glossed over at the end of the season 1. So hopefully we get that episode too. But yeah, so Zombies is also going to be getting a series. It's also going to be getting a season 2, they announced already. So yeah, they also kind of revealed the cast that's going to be taking place in Marvel Zombies. I believe the cast includes Ghost from Ant-Man and the Wasp, Shang-Chi, Jimmy Woo, Yelena from Black Widow, Kate Bishop from Hawkeye, Red Guardian also from Black Widow, and Kamala Khan and Death Dealer, who was also in Shang-Chi. So we got all them. We also got some little concept art of some of the zombies that are going to be in the show. We got the return of like Captain America, who's cut in half, zombie Scarlet Witch, zombie Hawkeye. We also got our first look at what looks like it's going to be a zombie Icarus from the Eternals. Don't know how that works with Icarus not being an actual person, but like a synthetic. But who knows? I guess we'll see. So, so Marvel Zombies, I don't think they gave a date for a release year for it yet, or release date like the others. But yeah, so that's coming as well. Oh, there was also Abomination was in there too. It's really cool the fact that like Abomination is coming back for a lot of stuff. Also, as always, super dope that Charlie Cox's Daredevil is coming back for Spider-Man 2. But we'll have a little bit more on that a little later. So yeah, so that was all of Marvel's animation roundup. We also had a few random trailers that kind of popped up there. We got Dungeons and Dragons, Autumn Themes released its first trailer. It stars Chris Pine, freaking Michelle Rodriguez, a bunch of other people whose name I can't remember right now. But it looks a little entertaining. It doesn't come out till 2023, but they just kind of just showcased the first look at it at Comic-Con. But, it looks pretty good. You know, it can't be as bad as the first Dungeons & Dragons live-action movie. Also, we got they revealed Teen Wolf, the movie trailer. That's going to be coming to Paramount Plus. Also, what's really cool, the Rick and Morty spinoff, The Vindicators, was teased and actually released the very next day that they actually revealed that it was coming. But it was all released on YouTube, so it was just like a 5-episode short episodes. Like, each episode is maybe like 5-8 minutes or something, but it's like 5 episodes. They're all on YouTube. You can all go watch it. So, yeah, more Rick and Morty is never a bad thing. We also got our first look at John Wick Chapter 4, John Wick 4, however you want to call it. Just a little small, little tease. So some action shots, some establishing, you know, shots, a bunch of people meeting. And I swear, every time I see a trailer for one of these, I'm like, I still have not watched a John Wick movie all the way through. The most I've watched is one, and I've seen that in just like a lot of just chunks and bits and pieces as it comes on syndication on TV. But I've never sat down and watched it from beginning to end all the way through. And I still haven't seen 2, and I still haven't seen 3. And I swear, every time they make a new one, I'm like, I really need to go watch these other movies to catch up on it. And I never do, and they keep making new ones, and every time I say the same thing, and I never do it. So I need to watch John Wick 1-3, and so I can get ready for 4, which comes out March 2023, I believe they said. So that's kind of some other random trailers to kind of pay attention to. The Walking Dead also held a panel. Of course, they released the trailer for the final batch of episodes for the final season. That's coming up in October. I've been catching up. I'm kind of ready. I just need to watch the second part of the final season. So I've been watching them, getting catching up, because I'll be there for the end. I was there at the beginning, so I figured I might as well get ready to get there for the end. So yeah, pretty, as you can imagine, it was pretty emotional for some people. A lot of characters up there, very emotional for them. This being the finale for it's been like 12 years, but there are only 2 people who've been around since season 1. But yeah, still very, you know, pretty emotional time for them. So yeah, they'll just find a batch of episodes there. But the biggest thing was that they had a surprise announcement. Oh, also they released the first trailer for Tales of the Walking Dead, which is an anthology spinoff of the series, which is going to star like Terry Crews in an episode, Jesse T. Usher is in an episode. But yeah, it's just an anthology series, so yeah. But the big surprise was that they finally gave an update on those goddamn Rick, the Rick movies that were supposed to be happening. So it was announced that the series is not going to be movies anymore. They aren't going to be a trilogy of TV movies anymore. Instead, they're readjusting them. It's going to be a 6-episode mini run. So it's just going to be a series, 6 episodes. And instead of just having Rick be the focus, it's going to be a Rick and Michonne focus series. So Danai Gurira is also coming back to reprise her role as Michonne, as well as Andrew Lincoln coming back as Rick Grimes. So we can finally find out what the hell happened to Rick Grimes after he got taken out of the series back in, I can't remember what season it was, but you know, like, I think it might have been 8 or something. But yeah, he left the series about halfway through one season, so it was half of a season he was there, then he left, and then they did a time jump for the second half of the season. So yeah, we finally get to find out what the hell happened to Rick Grimes when he was taken away on that helicopter. But we also get to find out what happened to Michonne after she found evidence of what happened to Rick, and she went off on her own to search for him. So yeah, finally it's happening, because I've been watching the series, and I've been catching up, and I got to the episode where Rick was left. I got to the episode where Rick left. Then I got to the Michonne's final episode, Danai Gurira's final episode. And the whole time I've just been wondering is what the hell is going on with these Rick Grimes movies. And we finally get our answer in this 6-episode run. So I'm happy that they finally announced it. And finally we got some kind of damn update on what was going on with these. I'll probably treat that series as my closing the book on the Walking Dead TV series. Like I said, I've been rewatching the main series. I'm not gonna lie, A few of those seasons, actually, after Rick left, were pretty good. Everything but, like, The Whisperers, that was all actually really good. The whole Whisperer War stuff was actually really good. And that was actually a surprise, because I kind of figured, like, after Rick left, the show would kind of just fall off a cliff, especially the way everything worked with, like, the all-out war stuff and fighting against the Saviors. I figured that it was going to get bad. But, yeah, actually, everything with the Whisperers was actually really good. Unfortunately, after that, it kind of went back to middling. Even like the final season, I feel like hasn't been that good. The first few episodes was just like a very much felt like a side quest, side mission, side content stuff that they kind of had to just introduce to really start it to bring forward the main issue that it seems like it's gonna be, that kind of happened in the background. So we'll see once I watch the second half of the final season, and then, of course, when the final season rolls around. But, yeah, they also got this, like I said, Tales of the Walking Dead is about to come out. It's an anthology series. Probably not going to be too interested in that. Have kind of wanted to check out Fear the Walking Dead for a little bit. I heard that one was actually pretty good. But then it also kind of had, like, a massive cast change from the original cast, and it kind of shifted to a whole other cast. They kind of killed or wrote everybody off. And after that happened, it seemed like it kind of didn't continue to be as good. But I have been a little interested, just mostly because of the cast. Like, Lenny James is on it, who plays Morgan in the main series. He was on there. Austin Emilio, who played Dwight in the series, he moved over there. Also had, like, Maggie Grace from Lost, and Garrett Dillahunt on there from Army of the Dead. I know him from Raising Hope. He was in there as well. So I was kind of interested to watch it. Also, I had her name in my mind, but now I just cannot remember her name. I don't know. She's Ashley in The Boys, and I forget who she played. I forget her character's name in Jessica Jones, but she was in Jessica Jones as well. She's also in there. So I was interested just for the cast, but I heard it just wasn't that good. So I probably won't even really watch that. I might watch The World Beyond, because apparently some things in there kind of explain, like, the origins of the zombie virus. And it seems like the group, the community that is featured in that series seems like it might be the community that took Rick. So I've been thinking about maybe watching that one. So I might check that one out. But yeah, once the main series is over, and whenever this series comes out, that'll probably be my ending of the Walking Dead series, the TV series, at least. I still want to read the comic books. I've read a little bit of them, but I still want to read those. So yeah, big announcements for The Walking Dead there. DC, of course, also had a panel there. When you compare it to the Marvel panel, I mean, they still have things. They're still trying stuff. but yeah, some announcement that came there. Shazam! Fear of the Gods had its first trailer was released. That's looking pretty solid. We also had another, of course, look at Black Adam. Dwayne Johnson showed up in full Black Adam costume, you know, played to the crowd and everything. So that was pretty cool. But yeah, that's kind of like the only thing DC has going for them right now. I mean, at least that they want to showcase. Of course, The Flash is still coming out this year. But of course, at this point, you don't want to have Ezra Miller. You don't want to have Ezra Miller there. Everything that's been going on with them so far. So they didn't really have Ezra Miller there. I don't even think they had a Flash panel there because of the whole Ezra Miller situation. So yeah, that's fun. DC, they're trying. They're still trying stuff. They're still going there. But also, this wasn't at Comic-Con, but it was also been recently revealed that Ben Affleck is reprising his role as Batman in the second Aquaman movie. So just a little news that just kind of recently broke that I'll figure out share here. So yeah, DC panel, they're trying. But of course, it turns out that it was a blessing in disguise that they went first, because what ended that day was huge. Of course, Marvel returned to Comic-Con. They took a few years off. I didn't have anything last year. And of course, like I said, Comic-Con didn't even happen in 2020. So it's been quite a while. Actually, I think even before that, they took a few appearances off too. Actually, I think the last time they even appeared at Comic-Con was like maybe when like they announced like a bunch of Phase 4 stuff, when like the Inhumans was still on the slot and stuff. So it's been a while since Marvel's done a Comic-Con thing. So, but they did not disappoint. So they revealed the full slate of Phase 5. Now, currently, we're still in Phase 4, but they have announced Black Panther Wakanda Forever is going to be the end of Phase 4. They have announced that Phase 4 has kind of just been a phase that's been a mix of one being reactions to the events of Endgame, but also kind of starting out, putting in the first few touches and first few glimpses of what's now been dubbed as the Multiverse Saga. So the Infinity Saga was, of course, phases 1 through 3, everything from Iron Man all the way up to Spider-Man Far From Home. That was all the Infinity Saga, of course, everything with the Infinity Stones and Thanos. But now we officially have what this next saga is called. It is officially called the Multiverse Saga. So Phase 4 was very much reactions to Endgame and also getting our first couple glimpses at the multiverse for the Multiverse Saga. But it seems like Phase 5 is going to be full on Multiverse Saga stuff. So, first of all, they announced the full slate. So, first of all, actually, for things that have yet to come for Phase 4, they revealed a brand new final trailer for She-Hulk Attorney at Law. Still looking pretty good. Daredevil is making an appearance in the series. Matt Murdock is making an appearance. Of course, role being reprised by Charlie Cox, which one thing to take away from Marvel San Diego stuff is that they are going all in on Charlie Cox's Daredevil. We'll find out more in a little bit. So yes, they released the final trailer for She-Hulk, and they released the first trailer for Black Panther Wakanda Forever. And man, I'm not gonna lie, this trailer brought me to tears. Like, it is, like, the shots are just beautiful and gorgeous. They have just like this mix of music. It's I didn't look too much into it, but it's somebody doing a cover of a Bob Marley song, No Woman, No Cry, and it's also mixed with Kendrick Lamar's All Right. And man, this trailer, it is just beautiful. It's powerful, it's exciting, it's swelling. It just brought me to tears. Revealed our first look at Namor, who's appearing in the movie. Of course, they brought out the whole cast, which includes the new additions to the movie, which includes the actor portraying Namor. I didn't write this down anywhere, so I'm gonna try to say his name off the top of my head. Tanakwerta, I believe that's his name. But yeah, they're giving the Atlanteans and Namor this very Aztec Mayan aesthetic and very look to him, which I absolutely love. The actor is, of course, a Mexican-American actor they have portraying Namor, and I love just all of that stuff they have going for Atlantis and the Atlanteans in here. It looks so dope. But yeah, man, this trailer was just powerful. And the tease at the very end, somebody is stepping into the Black Panther suit, who, of course, at this point, we don't know. It is being highly believed that it's going to be Letitia Wright's Shuri, who's going to be taking on the mantle of Black Panther. But of course, we'll have to wait and see. There's also another smaller rumor that Michael B. Jordan is supposedly coming back to portray Njidaka, who's going to be stepping into the suit. So we'll have to wait and see. Black Panther Wakanda Forever is releasing in November, so very hyped for that. So yeah, so they announced those two are going to be our final entries into Phase 4. Phase 5, of course, is going to be the next phase. Phase 5 is, of course, going to kick off with Ant-Man and the Wasp Quantumania, which they just showed a little teaser just for Hall H, just for the Comic-Con. A lot of people in attendance, so we did, you know, us regular old folks just watch it on YouTube and whatnot, we didn't see what they showed. Yes, but of course we know that Jonathan Majors is going to be playing Kang the Conqueror in this series. He did play a variant of Kang in the Loki series, but it seems like he's going to be playing full Kang for Ant-Man and the Wasp Quantumania. And so with that, everything else coming in Phase 5 is also going to include Echo, which is, of course, the spinoff from the Hawkeye series. And that one of Vincent D'Onofrio's Kingpin and, of course, Charlie Cox's Daredevil are both slated to make an appearance in the show. We also have, of course, Secret Invasion, which is going to star Samuel Jackson and Ben Mendelsohn. Still don't have too much on what's going on in that. But very excited. Kobe Smulders came out to talk about it a little bit. So she's apparently coming back to reprise her role as Maria Hill in the series. Of course, the next big movie, finally we're getting it. Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3. Very long awaited. Very anticipated. I'm super excited for this. They're about to cast out. Again, they showed a little first look, first trailer just for those in attendance. So, of course, we didn't see it. It seems like this movie is kind of going to explore the origins of Rocket Raccoon. Of course, the Cavs got very emotional being on that stage again. Of course, after everything that happened with James Gunn being kicked out, the Cavs very much rallying behind him. They all claim that, you know, there's nobody else that they could bring into here to kind of close off this adventure with anybody else but James Gunn. So, yeah, it was a very emotional time for all the cast. Zoe Saldana and Dave Bautista weren't there. But, it was very emotional for the whole cast, seeing everything up there. You could tell they were getting choked up, tearing up and everything as they were talking to the crowd. So, I'm super excited for Guardians 3. I've been waiting for that for a very long time. We also have Season 2 of Loki, which is coming. Seems like, of course, that's going to kind of explore more of the multiverse stuff. Probably explore more with Kang the Conqueror, with the way the last season ended, so we shall see. That one is currently filming right now, I believe. Also, of course, we have the Marvels. After Ms. Marvel, we kind of seen the first little tease and setup of that. That is also currently filming. We also have Ironheart, which is coming. Of course, Dominic Thorne is playing Ironheart. She's making her debut in Black Panther Wakanda Forever, and then she's going to get her own series here. Dominic Thorne was there on the stage with the Black Panther cast. So yes, that's coming later. We also had our first date for Blade, Mahershala Ali playing Eric Brooks, starring as Blade. We got our first date for that, November 3rd, 2023. Super hyped about that. We also had Agatha, formerly known as the House of Harkness, now known as Covenant of Chaos. That's also going to be in Phase 5, so the spinoff from the WandaVision series. And what got me hyped, and I'm pretty sure I got everybody else super hyped, Daredevil Born Again, I believe in the last news drop, which was so very long ago now, it was revealed that they were going into early production, kind of starting very early ideas for a Daredevil Disney Plus series, and it was officially announced at Comic-Con, Daredevil Born Again. It is going to be a whopping 18-episode run. Charlie Cox is coming back. Vincent D'Onofrio is coming back. That's what I mean when I said they seem to be going all in on Charlie Cox's Daredevil, getting him any and everywhere they can get him. So, super happy about this. We'll finally have our answer to how much of the actual Netflix series is about to be crossed over into the mainline MCU canon. So, super hyped about that. And of course, another movie that was officially confirmed, but now we have a date and a title, Captain America 4, Captain America New World Order, which is, of course, going to star Anthony Mackie as Sam Wilson, stepping into the boots of Captain America after the Falcon and the Winter Soldier series. So very happy about that. And then, of course, Kevin Feige revealed that capping off Marvel Phase 5 is going to be a film about the Thunderbolts. Of course, right before Comic-Con happened, it was revealed that Marvel had licensed a patent for the title of the Thunderbolts. So it has officially been revealed here that we are getting a Thunderbolts film coming to cap off Phase 5 in 2024. Kevin Feige also revealed that the lineup for the Thunderbolts is going to be revealed at D23, which happens in September. So we'll have our little roundup of that as well. So, even after all that, after all this new stuff was announced, Kevin Feige said, why the fuck should we stop here? So he also revealed some very few teases on what's coming beyond that. He revealed Phase 6, which I was completely shocked about. So yes, Phase 6, everything after Phase 5, well, not everything. We saw a few dates, few tentative little windows, you know, fall 2024, whatever, summer 2025 or whatnot. But he did reveal three entries that will be taking place in Marvel's Phase 6. So Phase 6 will kick off with, of course, the first family coming to the MCU for the first time, the Fantastic Four. That is going to be coming. So we got our first official date of it, which is November 8th, 2024. So super hyped about that. So he didn't go into anything else on Phase 6. He did tease that They might reveal more of what's on that slate, of course, at D23 in September. But he decided to do us all a favor and also reveal what is going to be capping off Phase 6 and also capping off the multiverse saga at the very end. And he revealed, at the very end, we are going to be getting, for the first time since Avengers Endgame back in, like, what, 2019? Two Avengers films, and they are going to be Avengers The Kang Dynasty. That is going to be coming, as of right now, May 2nd, 2025. And then at the very end, the thing that will end the multiverse saga and Phase 6, Avengers Secret Wars, that I knew was coming. If you listen to my Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness review, I said after that, I think that's what we're building to, and it's been officially confirmed at Comic-Con. Everything is building towards Secret Wars. So I am super, super hyped about that. So we're going to be getting, as of right now at least, two Avengers films in 1 year in 2025 as we cap off the multiverse saga for Marvel Phase 6. And I could not be happier. So yes, of course, we're going to be getting more Marvel news, like I mentioned, at D23 in September. So we'll find out more about Phase 6. We'll find out who's going to be the lineup for the Thunderbolts. And we may, just maybe, we're going to get our first official announcement of mutants/X-Men in the MCU. I'm kind of on it either way. I could definitely see them introducing them in Phase 6 before Secret Wars, but I could also definitely see them waiting until after the multiverse saga and then introducing them after that, and them kind of being more of the main focus for whatever phase and things were going after that. So we'll have to wait and see till D23 to find out. But yes, Marvel, of course, knocking it out of the park yet again. It was also announced not too long after San Diego Comic-Con, Destin Daniel Cretton, who of course directed Shang-Chi and The Legend of the Ten Rings, is going to be directing Avengers Kang Dynasty. No announcement on who's directing Avengers Secret Wars just yet, but it has of course been heavily rumored that the Russo brothers would be returning to direct, because they even said themselves that if they were going to return to direct any event, it was going to be Secret Wars. So we'll have to wait and see. So yes, that is our Comic-Con roundup here. Some Walking Dead stuff, Marvel stuff, DC stuff, a few little trailers for a few movies and shows coming in the future. But yeah, like I said, this kind of just randomly snuck up on me. Of course, Marvel walked away with the biggest news stories. So very happy about that. Very happy to see what we have in the future. If you've been listening to my Marvel reviews as of late, I have been having an issue with a lot of Marvel stuff being pretty mid lately. Like, the only things that have really blown me out of the water so far have been WandaVision, Shang-Chi, and of course, Spider-Man No Way Home. But everything else so far has just kind of been very, very mid-tier to me so far. So hopefully that has to do with the fact that, like they said, this phase has kind of been just reactions to Endgame and the blip and kind of setting up everything to do with the multiverse. So hopefully phase five really kind of improves in the quality. Hopefully Black Panther is really looking good, because god damn, that trailer was so good. So hopefully Black Panther is one of the really good ones. Hopefully She-Hulk is too. I'm kind of still on the fence. I'm kind of in the middle about everything I've seen so far. None of it has been fantastic, but nothing has been particularly terrible about any trailers or stuff I've seen. Also, apparently it's going to be the first like half hour comedy coming from Marvel. So it's kind of like a superhero comedy thing they have going for it. So we'll have to wait and see. But yes, that's our roundup for San Diego Comic-Con. A lot of things I'm excited about. A lot of things I'm looking forward to. Marvel, the finale of Walking Dead, John Wick 4, so hopefully I can catch up on John Wick movies. DC's still here. That's kind of what I took away from this. DC's still here. They still got movies happening. They still doing stuff. So, yeah. But anyway, that's it for me here. This kind of went on longer than I thought it would. But please, just Follow and subscribe on all the platforms, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Amazon Music, Stitcher Radio. We're on all of those. Follow and subscribe so you can get updated on all the releases that are coming from here on Geek Visions. So until next time, everybody, always remember, keep watching, keep playing, and stay awesome. All right, until next time, I'll see you later. Goodbye.